Former FBI Joint Terrorism Task Force member Steve Rogers. He's also a member of the Donald J. Trump for President Advisory Board and a former Trump campaign advisor. Captain America,
it's
been a long time. You know, this is another one of these terms everyone's throwing out there, right? An FBI investigation. It could be a week. It could be a month. Greg Jarrett said it could be a day. I mean, how does it work?
Well, here's what's happened. Charles, this is, in all my years in law enforcement, this was a travesty of justice. It really was regarding Judge Kavanaugh. So now you have a mandate of an FBI investigation, and I believe they want this done in a week. Well, in a week, the FBI is going to have to talk to the accuser, talk to Judge Kavanaugh, talk to anyone that they lead the FBI to. You're talking about potential witnesses, you're talking about locations, times. It is impossible for the FBI to do a thorough investigation within a week. Impossible.
All right, just so the audience knows, Senator McConnell's just adjourned the Senate. There will be no weekend weekend session, so they will meet back on Monday. So the FBI will speak to all of the names that we've heard in the public. Those folks may give them additional names. Those additional names may give them additional names. I mean, this thing can have tentacles and start to go places where no one knows. I mean, the clock is ticking. Apparently, it's a one-week investigation. Yes. I'm not sure if the FBI has ever dealt with those sort of parameters or restrictions before. So what's a priority here?
Well, keep in mind, Charles, this is not a criminal investigation. This is certainly a background investigation. The priority is going to be to talk to the accuser again. That's Dr. Ford. Talk to Judge Kavanaugh. And then they're going to have to just recycle everything that we've heard in the past few days.
Some of the key names that we heard, Judge, who apparently has issued some sort of statement that he's willing to speak in some sort of a confidential setting to the FBI or anyone else, and maybe some of the other names. Leland, who's been mentioned by Dr. Ford, but says she has no recollection of anything that's happening. Those have to be high priorities as well.
They will be high priorities, but what if the FBI sees one of them and they said, look, I don't want to talk to you? They're not compelled to talk to the FBI. They may not want to get involved. What we see here, this has turned into political. Look, we all know it's about Roe versus Wade. We all know it's about a delaying tactic past the midterms. But the president of the United States would not pick this man without a thorough background investigation.
I get that because, you know, you're with the Trump team. But as a law enforcement expert, I'm really shocked that you say these folks have the ability or the right to say, no, I'm not going to speak to you.
Yeah, they're not compelled. I remember investigations. I'd go to witnesses, suspects. I'm not talking to you. You cannot compel them to speak to you at all unless you get a subpoena, unless you've got some sort of charges against them. And even then, you've got to give them their rights. They get a right to an attorney. So you see, as you said, how far wide
and
how far reaching this could be.
All right. Steve, it's great seeing you.
Well, it was a pleasure to see you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
All right, coming up, we're going to break down what...